Ladies and gentlemen, the Crusades were in response to Mohammedan jihadi aggression against Christian pilgrims to the Holy Land and not the other way around. Jihad was started by Muhammad 400 years earlier. It was the followers of Muhammad who only 3 years after his death embarked upon the fastest, largest, and most oppressive imperialism the world had ever witnessed until then. In 100 years, the Arabs conquered, occupied, subjugated, terrorized, and enslaved tens of millions of peoples on 3 continents, not one of which had attacked the Arabs in their land in the first place. But the Mohammedans claim these were all in self-defense. They converted the holy shrines, cathedrals, churches, and temples of the Christians, Jews, Zoroastrians, Hindus, and Buddhists into mosques without once in this 21st century returning any of them to their rightful people. They used the knowledge in all branches of human endeavor, those of the Greeks, Romans, Hebrews, Persians, Indians, Chinese, and others, that were interpreted to Arabic by mostly Christians and Jews of the empire, to build what they called the Islamic civilization and sciences, as if they actually were the ones who invented them all, by willfully ignoring the sources of their knowledge unto this day. It was so-called Western imperialism that liberated the peoples of the Middle East and North Africa from the oppressive yoke of 500 years of the Ottoman Turks. This so-called imperialism lasted less than 100 years. It was Western imperialism that revived the history and culture of the Arabs and Africa through literary and archaeological research performed and conducted by Europeans without a single contribution on the part of the Arabs or the Mohammedans. It was Western imperialism that brought the Arabs and Mohammedans into the 20th century with electricity, running water, rail, roads, hospitals, education, constitutions, the foundations of democracy, archaeology, etc., etc. What did uncivilized and illiterate Arab imperialism bring to the conquered peoples besides subjugation, plunder, and taxation? The answer is obviously nothing, 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 since they had absolutely nothing of value to offer in the first place. While the Christians and the West regret their imperialism and the Crusades, the Arabs and the followers of Muhammad actually gloat and revel at their conquest and slaughter and have never regretted anything. While the so-called imperialist West have no further claims to any of the lands they had conquered in Asia and Africa, the Arabs still claim their rights to every single square mile of any and all the lands that they had subjugated, from Iraq, Syria, and Israel to Egypt, North Africa and Spain, from Persia to India and China. We witness daily the 90% acts of terror committed by the followers of Muhammad and the Arabs all over the world against not only so-called unbelievers, but also other believing sects of Mohammedan Islam. They only attack in the most cowardly manner, unarmed and unsuspecting civilian targets, just as Muhammad did 1400 years ago. But they claim they are a religion of peace who are only defending themselves. Once more, does history repeat itself, as the aggressor Mohammedans pretend they are the victims. Mohammedans refuse to integrate or assimilate in any of the countries that give them harbor, because the Quran forbids them from doing so, but they falsely and brazenly claim they are being discriminated against and marginalized by the host people. They claim to be loyal to the democracies they live in, but in reality, they cannot ever be loyal, since they are forbidden in the Quran from doing so. That is why we have never had a single demonstration by any major Mohammedan Muslim organization against the acts of terror perpetrated in the names of Allah and Islam against targets in New York, London, Madrid, Bali, Mumbai, or any other around the world. While they demand all human rights for themselves and the democracies, they deny even the most basic ones to the minorities of Christians, Buddhists, Hindus, and Jews that live among them. While they are free in the democracies to follow their cult belief system, They oppress and terrorize their minorities so as not to perform their religious traditions in public. They demand the right to wear the hijab and niqab in our democracies, but forbid our females from exposing their bodies in their countries. The Arabs and Mohammedans in 55 states, in all their media, their school books, and their mosques, attack, insult, and demonize the beliefs of the Christians, Buddhists, Hindus, and Jews, but demand respect for theirs. They claim they are the victims of racism, when in fact and reality, the Arabs and Mohammedan Islam are the most racist peoples on the face of the earth. They hate 80% of humanity who are called unbelieving kuffar, which is religious bigotry. They blatantly and mercilessly discriminate against, subjugate, and humiliate their women, almost 700 million females, by their Sharia law, which is gender racism, but nonetheless claim they are the most egalitarian of all beliefs. They are the only belief system in human existence that arrogates to itself alone the right to be the only belief in the whole world because it is allegedly the best, but then claim they are not aggressive or racist. In summation, fundamentalist Mohammedan Muslims exhibit an obscene degree of hypocrisy, mendacity, and racism, compounded with a pathological and depraved indifference to facts, reality, compassion, mercy, loyalty, beliefs, friendship, and language, but are in total denial of any and all of the above.